was up in the upper deck for that first period. The war of chants between the fans is amazing. Couldn't have asked for much better an environment.
You know what? We have the greatest fans. Look at this building today down here in the U.S. And we have such great support from everyone. Our volunteers, our partnership with the Canadian Hockey League, everyone in the game.
After the win in the quarterfinal, Steve Yzerman paid the team a visit. They've got text messages from Crosby. The support all the way up into the pro ranks is pretty unreal.
You know what? That's what it's all about. And we're going to try to build that structure even stronger. And that's what makes it so special in Canada.
Thanks, Bob.
Thank you.
And we say hello to all the Team Canada alumni watching this game. Joe Sackett was texting earlier. Watching down in Denver. We're all over the place. There's Emerson Edom. The other night, when Buffalo played Boston, there were 12 former Team Canada players on the rosters of the two teams. And that puck bounces up into the U.S. bench. So Canada with a 3-0 lead. And 10:29 to go in the second period.
Well, part of that support that Brian was talking about with Bob Nicholson is the alumni, obviously. And these players know they're part of an unbelievable legacy. And they don't want to let anybody down.
And the report picks up the loose puck. Ryan Bourque.
He's not going to miss many more very often attorney like this. Ryan Bourque turns it over. An aggressive court check played by Couturier in all alone on Campbell. And there's a right pass coming out. And here's the flurry as it continues. Quinton Howard had a spin around chance. Rick Conley poking away at Jack Campbell.
It was a house down low for the Americans. Jack Campbell, who joined the Windsor Spitfires this year. Two-time defending Memorial Cup.